Hey there, Benjamin from Loves Data here, welcome back. In this video, we're going to look at segments in Google Analytics 4, GA4. Segments allow you to focus your report on particular sections of your traffic. For example, you might want to focus on people in particular geographic locations or people who found your website in organic search results who also converted. Or maybe you want to see people who made a purchase after watching a video embedded on your website. Segments allow you to achieve this in GA4. You can create and apply segments when you're using the exploration reports in Google Analytics 4. So this means you will need to create an exploration report and a segment. This is different to the previous version of Google Analytics, Universal Analytics, where segments could be saved and applied across default and custom reports. Let's head to GA4 to take a look. I've already opened Google's GA4 demo property and we're looking at the home report. As I just mentioned, segments are only available when you create Explore reports, so you'll need to navigate to Explore in the main menu on the left. This means if you're looking at Home, Reports, Advertising, or Configure, then you won't be able to apply segments. Now let's select Explore. We can now create an exploration report in Google Analytics, or we can view and edit an existing report. Across the top, you can also see the different types of exploration reports you can create in GA4. We can create freeform reports, funnel and path reports, segment overlap reports, and more. You can apply segments to any of these exploration reports. I like to start from scratch, so I'm going to travel back and click blank. This will create a blank freeform report by default. Let's name the report US and non-US users. Okay, on the left we can see there is an option to add segments, dimensions, and metrics to use in our report. Let's click the plus sign next to segments. At the top we can see types of custom segments we can create. These are user segments, session segments, and event segments. Below this, we can see segments that are automatically suggested for us. For Google's GA4 demo property, we can see suggestions include recently active users, users who haven't purchased, and users who have purchased. And if we select the Templates tab, we can then see segments for demographics, technology, and acquisition. And finally, we can select the Predictive tab. These predictive segments become available if you meet Google's minimum requirements. This is because predictive audiences rely on a minimum amount of data to ensure they're accurate. For Google's GA4 property, we can see a number of predictive segments based on purchase events. Today we're going to focus on custom segments, so I want to begin by explaining the difference between user, session, and event-based segments. Overall, the different types of segments let you control how much detail is included or excluded from your report. Here we can see the relationship between events, sessions, and users. When someone comes to your website and loads a page and performs other actions, like clicking an outbound link, watching a video, or making a purchase, then all of these actions are sent to Google Analytics as events. Events are then combined into sessions. A session is a single visit to your website. So if someone comes to your website on Tuesday morning and navigates through a number of pages, then all of these events will be combined into a session. Sessions are then associated with each user that visits your website. For example, if someone visits your website on Tuesday and then comes back on Thursday, then you'll have one user along with two sessions. So the different types of segments let you decide if you want to match individual events, sessions, or users. For example, let's say you want to create a segment for people who viewed the contact page on your website. You can choose to define an event-based segment that only includes the contact page. Or you can define a session-based segment that will include all of the details for the session that included the person viewing the contact page. Or you can define a user-based segment that will include all of the details for the user if they viewed the contact page during any of their sessions. So the type of segment you choose really comes down to what you want to see in your report. Okay, let's head back to Google Analytics. We're going to create a segment for people located in the US. So let's select User Segment. And let's name the segment US Users. Now let's click Add New Condition. And let's search for and select Country ID. Now we click Add Filter. And change Contains to Exactly Matches. And enter US as the value. And click Apply. We can now see a summary for the segment on the right. We can see the number of users included in the segment, along with the number of sessions for these users. Now let's click Save. And let's create a segment for everybody located outside of the United States. Let's click the plus sign next to Segments again. Let's choose User Segment. Let's name the segment Non-US Users. And let's click Add New Condition. Let's search for and select Country ID. And let's click Add Filter. Now let's change Contains to Does Not Exactly Match and enter US as the value. And click Apply. This segment will now include users from all countries outside the United States. Now let's click Save. We can now see both of our segments have been applied to our report. So the next step is to add dimensions and metrics. Let's click the plus sign next to Dimensions. And let's search for and select Item Name. And click Import. Now let's click the plus sign next to Metrics. And let's search for and select e-commerce purchases. And let's also search for and select e-commerce revenue. Now let's click Import. We can now see the dimension and metrics on the left. And we can drag the dimension under rows. And we can drag the metric under values. We can now see the items people are purchasing based on the number of purchases and revenue. And we can also see this split by the segments we created and applied to the report. Okay, now we're going to create another report that includes two segments based on how people are finding our website. We're going to create one segment for our organic traffic and another for our paid traffic. Let's head back to Google Analytics. Let's navigate back. And let's click blank again. Let's name the report Organic and Paid Pages. This time, let's start by adding dimensions and metrics to our report before we create our segments. Let's click the plus sign next to Dimensions. And let's search for and select Page Title. Now let's click Import. And let's click the plus sign next to Metrics. And let's search for and enable Views. And Sessions. And Conversions. Now let's click Import. And let's add the dimension under Rows. And the metrics under Values. Now let's create our segments. Let's click the plus sign next to Segments. let's choose Session Segment, and let's name the segment Organic Traffic. Now let's click Add New Condition, and let's scroll down, and select Traffic Source. This shows us the dimensions we can use to create our segment. You'll notice that there are only a handful of options for our traffic sources, and there's currently only one option for session-based dimensions, which is the Session Default Channel Grouping. Not all of the dimensions we can find in reports are automatically available to use with our segments. However, since the traffic source, medium, and campaign are automatically collected as parameters with our page view events, we can still create segments based on the value of these parameters. If you'd like to learn more about events, parameters, and custom definitions, I recommend checking out my GA4 courses and my other tutorials on YouTube. I've included links in the description below this video. Okay, so to use parameters that are automatically collected, let's scroll back to the top and select Events. Now let's scroll down and select Page View. And let's click Add Parameter. Now let's search for and select Medium. Let's select Exactly Matches. And let's enter Organic as the value. Now let's save our segment. We can now see our organic traffic in the report. And let's create a segment for our paid traffic. Let's click the plus sign next to Segments again. Select Session Segment. Name the segment Paid Traffic. And click Add New Condition. Now we select Events, then Page View. Let's click Add Parameter, and search for and select Page Location. Let's leave Contains, and enter GCL ID as the value. This will match any pages people land on with the parameter from Google Ads. Let's click Apply. And now let's click OR. Let's click Add New Condition again, then Events. Let's select Page View again. Click Add Parameter, then search for and select Medium. Now we can select Matches Regular Expression and enter CPC Pipe Paid. Click Apply. And save the segment. This segment will then include any sessions that are from Google Ads or that include CPC or paid as their medium. So that's how you can segment your reports in Google Analytics 4 GA4. Remember that you can only apply segments to the exploration reports. And the great thing about segments is that you can apply up to 4 segments at once to your reports to compare how they perform. I also recommend checking out the segment overlap report that lets you see if users are matched to multiple segments. Are you using segments in GA4? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.